Hello guys, welcome to the Oddspedia channel. After a short break, the big football competitions are about to start. Later than ever, but we just enjoyed the final of the Champions League some days ago. So, only we had a few days to enjoy the beach before getting ready for the new season. And one of the first competitions to start is La Liga. So let's talk about the outright odds for La Liga, some interesting bets you can place before the tournament starts, and let's analyze, of course, the first games now. For La Liga fans, it's been a very sad summer, I would say. A lot of talent has been lost, and I think the competition is losing little by little the quality it used to have, in favor, of course, of the Premier League, signing the best players of La Liga. For instance, Rodrigo Moreno left Valencia for Leeds, James Rodriguez left Real Madrid and joined Everton, and Luis Suarez is on his way to, in this case, Serie A to Juventus. But at least Leo Messi stayed finally at Barcelona. We are going to analyze almost everything and how we can make bets in the long term for La Liga. But first, let's check out the outright odds for this competition. You know that La Liga is usually a two-horse race, and it should be the same this year. I don't really see, to be honest, Atletico de Madrid fighting for the title, especially because they changed nothing in comparison to last season. And the gap is also too big with Sevilla, even if their project is very interesting. So here we can check the outright odds for La Liga. And the favorites to win the title are Real Madrid with 172 odds. And I think it's pretty fair to think that this is going to be already the second full season for Zinedine Zidane after he came back to the club. And last year, despite the problems they had, Real Madrid ended up the season pretty well. During the summer, they got rid of some big players, I would say, like James Rodriguez or Ashraf Hakimi. Real Madrid needed money. But Gareth Bale, who also Zidane wants to get rid of him, is still in the squad. Let's see until the end of the transfer market. The only signing is Odegaard, who last season was on loan at Real Sociedad. However, Los Blancos, I think they should improve this season, especially with all the eyes set on Eden Hazard, whose first season was really, really poor. Also, Marco Asensio was injured and should be an important man. And youngsters like Rodrigo, like Vinicius or Valverde should be even more important. On the other hand, we have their rivals, Barcelona, whose crisis is still gigantic. Probably it was their worst summer in decades after the historic 8-2 received from Bayern Munich. So Setien was sacked and Ronald Koeman was appointed manager. The Dutch needed to clean the dressing room and they lost names like Ivan Rakitic, Luis Suarez or Arturo Vidal. But the bomb was still to arrive and it was by Burofax. This is the most important one during this summer. It's what Messi sent the club, telling that he wanted to leave. At the end, we all know he's staying, but let's see how is his commitment with the club. Odds for Barcelona to win La Liga are 2.88. And then we have Atletico de Madrid, 10.0 odds for Simeone's men. Remember that they won La Liga for the last time in 2014. And they always compete under Simeone. However, their last seasons in La Liga were quite disappointing, especially if we think that Real Madrid and Barcelona are also showing, I would say, a poor level. So no big signings for them this summer, no big sales neither, although there are some players like Diego Costa, for instance, that they could leave the club until October. Let's see what happens until the end of this transfer window. and we can also place a bet on who is going to be in the top four and therefore play in the next edition of the Champions League. Here we should agree that Real Madrid, Barcelona and Atletico de Madrid, although Simeone's team struggled last year to clinch the top four spot, should be on the top four. And then we can check here the odds, because the trickiest part comes when we talk about the fourth team to qualify. We have Sevilla with 1.57 odds and Villarreal with 3.75. Sevilla made a great season last year. They won the Europa League, they finished La Liga fourth. So this season, I would say, is gonna be tougher with them, especially if they have to play the Champions League. Against Monchi made some interesting signings, like Ivan Rakitic, who is coming back to Sanchez Pizjuan. Only they pay 1.5 million. But they've lost Banega and Sergio Reguilón, for instance, two important players last season. And you should keep a close eye on Villarreal, probably the best Spanish team this summer in the market. And they have a very interesting project. The captain of the boat is Unai Emery, and they got Coquelin and Parejo from Valencia, for instance, whose team is really falling apart, and also another youngster like Kubo on loan from Real Madrid. Unfortunately, they also lost two great players in La Liga, like Santi Cazorla and Bruno Soriano. Then it's more unlikely, I could say, to see a surprise here for the fourth place. We have Real Sociedad with 7.0 odds or Getafe with 9.5. Valencia, once upon a time the third team in Spain, have 12.0. And then we can also play our bet on the bottom three, the ones who are gonna be relegated to Segunda División. Check here the odds. The favorites to go down again to Segunda División are actually the ones that were promoted last year. So we have Elche, Huesca and Cádiz. But be careful, because I think Cádiz, they have actually a very nice project, and they signed Álvaro Negredo. We all know him because he played for Valencia, for Real Madrid, even for Manchester City. Eibar can also be a candidate to go down, and they have 2.30 odds. But I don't see Osasuna having this year problems, even if their odds are quite low, or even Levante. Alaves, they have an interesting squad, but last season they struggled a lot, so let's see how they manage this year. And if you enjoyed these videos, please subscribe to our channel and do not forget to click on the bell to get notifications whenever we publish new videos. Also, thumbs up for the video if you are loving it. And just a reminder, you can listen to all our videos on our Spotify podcast. Link to our podcast here below. We've seen the outright odds for La Liga. Now let's take a look on oddspedia.com to find the best odds for the first games of the season. It's important to notice that Real Madrid, Barcelona, Atletico de Madrid, Getafe and Sevilla won't play this first game because they all ended the season later because of the European competitions. So La Liga starts on Friday the 11th of September with Granada, Athletic Bilbao. You can check here the odds. Very interesting game, I would say, with two teams that did pretty well last season, especially Granada. And also, it could be the vendetta for the Copa del Rey semifinals. You remember, Athletic Bilbao got a spot in the final in a really balanced game against Granada. The odds are pretty high for both sides, but I would trust here Granada more, especially thinking that Athletic, they are never really too good out of San Mamés Stadium. I like here actually the double chance market with 1.54 for Granada or a draw. Then on Saturday we have Eibar Celta Vigo. Two teams that last year struggled a lot to stay in Primera División. Actually, Celta Vigo, if you remember well, they fought until the very last minute and they could have been relegated with one more goal scored by Leganés against Real Madrid in that last game. Oscar García kept the manager job and Celta has some good players in their squad, like Yago Aspas, of course, Santi Mina, Nolito or Denis Suárez. So I think they should be in the middle table. Eibar, though, I think they should struggle this season and I see really the best team fighting at the bottom of the table. Of course, they have Mendilibar, who is a really great coach and his job is terrific with Eibar. But the squad is not really great. Celta lost in their last two visits and we see Eibar is here the favorite. I tend to think the same, I would say. And on Saturday, we have also Cádiz-Osasuna. Cádiz is probably, if you don't know, one of the most loved teams in Spain. All football fans, and I would say everyone in Spain, like their city, their team, and its people. So we are very happy to see them again in Primera after 14 years. Credit here to the coach, Álvaro Cervera, who took the team in Segunda B, the Spanish third division. So, I guess it won't be easy to avoid relegation for them, but their project is very interesting. And they've signed very good players like Álvaro Negredo, for instance. This first game is against Osasuna, who made a great season last year, and I don't see them as struggling. They should avoid relegation, especially if Chimi Ávila is shining like last season. As you can see here, a very level game, even if I think Osasuna should get something at Ramón de Carranza. And they are a really good team, they have a little bit more experience in Primera, so it could be a really good option to back the Pamplona team in their visit to Cádiz. And for Sunday, we have these three games. Let's start with the first one, Real Valladolid, Real Sociedad. Real Sociedad was one of the best teams last season and they made an amazing signing, David Silva from Manchester City, who is gonna replace Martin Odegaard. I think we all expect a lot from Real Sociedad and Imanol Alguacil. They were probably one of the most enjoyable teams to watch last season, so we expect basically the same this year. They face in their first game Valladolid. You know that Ronaldo Nazario is the president, the chairman of the team. And in their third consecutive season in Primera with Sergio González as a manager, I think Valladolid should stay one more year. I really like this project. But they have a very tough team and a very tough challenge to start with. If everything is normal, I could go here for Real Sociedad with odds 2.65. I think it's also very appealing, even if their preseason was not very successful actually, but I think they should win in Valladolid. Then, second game, we have Villarreal Huesca. I said it before, I'm really, really interested in seeing this Villarreal with Unai Emery and his new signings. Of course, Villarreal, as you can see here on Otspedia.com, are really favorites, even if their preseason has been pretty bad. But, well, they play against a newly promoted team like Huesca, who is gonna play their second time in their history in Primera División. Actually, the first time they went up and then they got relegated. So the odds here, 1.64 for Villarreal. I think this is a really good deal. I would go for that without any hesitation. And the last game we have on Sunday is the Valencia's Derby. So Valencia's fans are really, really angry after a very difficult summer. Peter Lim, the owner, decided to get rid of most of the good players and stars like Dani Parejo, Rodrigo Moreno, Coquelin, Ferran Torres or Garay. All left the club. So the only good news they have is that they hired a good coach like Javi Gracia, and actually their preseason has been pretty good, I would say. They played against Levante, who is coached again by Paco López, and they should fight to stay in Primera one season more. We have here Valencia favorite with odds 2.10, but I wouldn't trust them, to be honest. Last year, even Levante drew at Mestalla, and I think an X year could be a good bet and a good idea for you. And the last game in this first week in La Liga is on Monday. We have Alavés Betis. Alavés has not won a single game this preseason, and they have Pablo Machín on the bench, former Sevilla coach last season. Also, I'm very curious to see this Alavés, because they struggle a lot this season and they have good players actually. They have Lucas Pérez, who played for Arsenal. We have Guidetti, they have Burgi. So it's not really bad. And they face Betis, who has Manuel Pellegrini on the bench after the bad season with Rubi last year. Betis won all the games in this preseason and they have a really good squad. I think they should be really close and fighting for European positions if Pellegrini get the best of this team. I would trust here also Betis to win and start the season with the right foot, and they are actually favorites. Also, a draw with 3.35 odds could be a good idea for you. So a lot of emotion in this first week of La Liga, even if Real Madrid, Barcelona, Atlético de Madrid, or Sevilla are not playing. Let me know in the comment section who is your favorite to win this La Liga title this season and if you agree with me. We will be back very soon with more info about betting and about La Liga. Bye!